Does hair transplantation leave permanent scars? I'd love a full head of hair, but the next best option for me is a shaved head. I'm worried that if I get transplants and I'm unhappy with the result, I'll lose the shaved head option because I'll have to cover up the scars. What can I expect as far as scarring, and is one method more prone to leave scars than another?
Thank you for your question. You submitted your question without a photo, and you're asking which type of hair transplant technique is preferable in case you're unhappy with the outcome and you decide to shave your head. Well, certainly I can help you understand the philosophy that guides me in counseling patients with hair loss before we take that step of moving forward with a hair transplant, and this will probably be beneficial to you depending on the degree of your hair loss. A little bit of background: I'm a board-certified cosmetic surgeon and fellowship-trained oculofacial plastic and reconstructive surgeon. I'm also a founder of TrichoStem Hair Regeneration Centers, a system we developed which evolved from hair transplant surgery, which is a non-surgical solution for men and women with thinning hair, and we treat patients who come to us from around the world with this method. I've been in practice in Manhattan, Long Island for over 20 years, and I have a lot of experience with hair transplant surgery. So again, to begin with, let's start before we move forward with which transplant procedure. I try to help my patients understand the very critical limitations of transplant surgery, regardless of technique, and the importance of doing things to maintain and stabilize as much as possible or slow down the progression of your current hair loss. You see, depending on the age of onset and the relative rate of progression, you are, with any transplant strategy, you are racing with time. And hair transplant is using a limited area of your scalp, which is the permanent zone of hair. And essentially, it is the area that never goes away, essentially the bar of hair that you see on a man who has very advanced hair loss. That is your true permanent zone. When you take that hair and you move it to the areas which are typically where it's needed, which is basically the front of the scalp, you are dealing with a limited resource. So essentially, there's a limitation right there. No matter how many times you go to that area, you're going to hit a wall. Now, there are advances now in body hair transplantation for those who are willing to do that. So that does mean you do have additional options, but it's a very small percentage of patients who actually go for that. So when we were doing hair transplant surgery a lot and we want to maximize the outcome, I mean, that is a very key issue. You've already stated that you're prepared in case you're unhappy. Well, the reality is that more than 65% of patients after hair transplant surgery, based on an International Society of Hair Restoration Surgery survey of its members, are not fully satisfied with the density after a transplant. And it's not for lack of quality of work. It's really the challenge of achieving a natural looking volume and density to create a satisfactory result. So when we were doing this, we were trying to help maximize the yield of grafts, and we're using platelet-rich plasma and ACellular matrix, which is a wound healing material. And a serendipitous result occurred, which was that thinning hair actually started to become thicker. And so what we developed over several years was a treatment called hair regeneration. Now, the reason I'm putting this in the context of your question is that what I figured out was that most of our patients who are coming for hair transplant consultations were losing hair. And when we figured out that we can actually help reactivate hair that isn't currently growing, prolong the growth cycle of hair that's present, as well as thinning hair, well, then we were able to actually exceed the results of one, if not two, transplants, with the understanding that it's only on people who still have hair. If your hair, scalp is smooth bald, that's not going to happen. Now, that being understood, we'd also, and I still suggest to our patients, male, to consider taking a drug like finasteride to help reduce their DHT levels. And essentially, I've developed over many years of managing patients with hair loss, a certain awareness of how DHT sensitive a lot of people are. Basically, my thinking is that when younger people have relatively rapid progression, they don't have the luxury of time compared to a middle-aged person who has slow progression. So very often, we'll actually recommend a DHT blocker as well as hair regeneration. So understanding that stabilization and maximizing whatever hair you currently have with this type of treatment is an option as long as you still have hair. Now, when it comes to this question about scarring, if you're going to shave your head, more than likely, in terms of scarring, then probably a FUE versus an FUT or the strip method is likely to be more acceptable, but technically speaking, an FUE creates a lot more scar tissue. And although the intention of FUE is to avoid the strip scar, the linear scar that people have objected to, essentially, if you shave your head, you may still see a lot of the dots from the FUE surgery. So there is no perfect solution there, and you really have to make sure you're comfortable with dealing with the realistic issues of the limitations of transplant before you move forward. Right now, there's always, like it's always been, essentially a race between doctors by promoting different technologies and claims of being better at XYZ transplant, but the limitations are still there, and invariably, a person who gets one transplant is highly likely to need a second transplant only a few years later. It's pretty much the trend because people seek attention for hair loss when they've already lost more than 50% of their hair. And so they're basically going downhill and losing a lot of hair proportionately that needs more coverage once you've committed to transplantation. So I think the take-home message is get a realistic assessment of where you are in terms of your hair loss. Learn about drugs like finasteride to slow down your progression, as well as technologies like we've developed called hair regeneration to help maximize the coverage of your hair, and you might be able to delay needing a transplant. With hair regeneration, just as a final note, we've been able to establish longevity of 5 years with our treatment. Of course, there are going to be some exceptions, but essentially our treatment system where we follow our patients for 5 years has worked out very, very favorably. And when it comes to hair loss, 5 years is a big deal. So again, consider all this, learn more, and then start having consultations with doctors to become comfortable with your decision before you get to that point where you regret doing it and have to shave your head. So I hope that was helpful. I wish you the best of luck, and thank you for your question.